we're three teenage boys. This means that we are the target demographic for the personal electric ceramic heater. Are you guys familiar with Brighttown as a company? Have you guys ever heard of this before?
I'm gonna be real with you. No.
Well, neither have I. But I took a gamble and I bought this because it was the cheapest space heater on Amazon. Daniel, why did I buy you this space heater?
Because my garage is freezing.
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 Doesn't have any insulation. Doesn't have any central heating, has literally nothing. So Daniel, could you give us a brief tour and show us all the reasons why it is an awful place to try and heat?
100%. So,
first of all, we got our handy dandy door. Now, this is a wonderful door for most garages, right? It goes up and it goes down, you know? It opens like doors should. Now here's the issue, my friends. It is open on the tops, sides, and bottom, which just lets air in. Now, on top of that, we have literally zero insulation on any of the walls. So cold air just seeps in. On top of that, we have a window with no insulation on the sides that opens and has two large cracks running through it, which again allows cold air to seep in. And over here in this dark and ominous hallway, we also have another door which doesn't actually shut. We have to use a latch to keep it closed, which also, like the big door, just lets air come in due to the big cracks. So it's not exactly the warmest when it is 45 degrees outside.
All right, so what's the temperature inside?
Inside,
we have our handy dandy,
it doesn't even fit in frame.
Handy dandy ground thermometer, and it says it is just about 48 degrees Fahrenheit.
It's about 45 degrees outside, 48 degrees inside. That's about the average. It's only about 2 to 3 degrees warmer in here than it is out there, and it's gonna get down to 42 tonight. As you can tell, the California warehouse has sold a lot of heaters because the box is actually like, it's actually like sun faded. It's been sitting in the warehouse for so long before we bought it. Kevin, do you mind describing the small issue we had with this ceramic heater?
Here's the thing. So as soon as we plugged it in, it began smelling like toxic burning plastic. Awful, like,
oh gosh.
It was so bad.
Breathe. It was so bad.
I've only smelled the specific scent that this ceramic heater gave off once in my life, and it was seconds before the motherboard in my NES melted and started a small fire that I had to put out. What we've done is that we've taken the heater and we put it outside, and we've had it run outside for about 2 hours to try and get rid of the awful toxic smell, because according to other Amazon reviewers, the toxic smell did go away after some time. So basically, the point of this review and the utility of it is that we have a very difficult heating situation. We have basically just a big wooden box. If it can do anything to this room, it'll do a fantastic job heating literally any room in your nice, warm, insulated apartment. What time is it, Koof?
11:06 p.m.
It's 11:06.
11:06.
We'll check back with you guys at midnight and see how well the little space heater has done in heating our crappy clubhouse.
And how sane we feel after breathing in the toxic fumes for that long.
All right, we're not even 5 minutes in and Kevin's already getting desperate, hogging all the heat.
I am starting to regain feeling in my hands.
1 hour later.
An hour has passed. What's the room temperature right now, Daniel?
Appears to be 48 degrees.
Exactly what it was when we last left off. Kevin, how has the tiny heater affected the space?
Well, the immediate space, I feel like there's a little aura of heat around it, but for the most part, if I'm sitting just a few feet back, I probably wouldn't feel it at all.
So right now, I'm taking a video with my iPhone to show you guys where the camera is in relation to the space heater. It's about, what, like 2.5 feet away from us, 3 feet? I can feel kind of like this hot, kind of like air kind of circulation, just like right next to us.
Very briefly.
Very, very, very lightly. It's still really cold in here.
Yeah.
We'll check in later this evening.
Yeah, we can hope maybe it'll get better over time.
But for the most part, the plastic smell has left, though. So
that's
if
true.
Any of you guys
it
are worried,
smell as toxic.
Yeah. After about a couple hours of use, it goes away pretty much entirely. All right, so we'll do some more advanced field testing to make sure it's done its job. But 1 hour in, it's gotten like maybe like a 4 foot radius around it. But other than that, the entire room is pretty much exactly where we left it.
1 hour later.
Daniel, what time is it?
2:01.
It is 2:01 in the AM, folks.
And that means that this heater has been running for 3 hours. 3 hours at this point.
Roughly.
And I believe the room has reached about the equilibrium of about as warm as it's gonna get.
Probably.
According to our decently sized thermometer, how cold is it in this room?
Like, almost exactly 50 degrees.
So we have kept this thermometer stored in the way, way back of that corner right there, and it is 50 degrees inside of this garage right now. Kevin, what's the temperature outside right now?
41, 42.
It is 41, 42 degrees. Typically speaking, we can only get it about 2 to 3 degrees warmer in here than it is out there. So this space heater has added about 8 degrees of warmth to this room. Admittedly, this is the warmest this room, I believe, has ever been during the winter, and I am eternally grateful for this machine. Do you think it did a successful job of warming this room?
Fairly successful.
What about you, Kevin?
I think as well as that small of a heater can do.
Yes, 100%.
Yeah. It helped. I believe it worked a little better than I expected. It's definitely not livable warmth. And you guys know how difficult this room is to heat. And if we can find this to be a relatively nice temperature, I mean, when I got close to the heater, I was actually able to take off my jacket. If you're within like a 3 foot radius, it's actually quite comfortable. Considering that the coldest parts of this room are 50 degrees and it's pushing 41 outside, I would say that this is a pretty good heater. What do you think, guys?
I think it's okay. Pretty good, yeah.
I think it's cute.
If you walk outside, you walk inside, there is a noticeable difference
yes,
in the temperature.
There is a big difference.
It is much better inside of here. I hope that us irreverent teenage boys in Southern California were able to sell you on this heater by pushing it through probably the worst humanly possible conditions for a heater of this size to go through. What are your recommendations, Kevin?
Like, if you're in this environment, in such a horribly insulated place, you need a real heater, don't get this. Like, this is okay, but we're testing it, basically. This would be perfect for a smaller insulated room. I think it would do a lot there. Here, it's not enough, but it shows that it does something here.
What about you, Daniel? What do you think about it?
Good for your office, not for the crappy garage.
Basically, what we've decided is that this little heater performs above average. It's better than we would expect from a little unit like this.
For sure.
So yeah, I give it a thumbs up. What do you guys think?
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up.
All right, thanks Amazon. Hope you guys enjoyed this review. Stay positive and have an awesome day.
Mr. White Christmas, I'm Mr. Snow. I'm Mr. Icicle, I'm Mr. Ten Below. Friends call me Snow Miser. Whatever I touch turns to snow in my clutch. I'm too much.